Hi, welcome to Kati Wi-Fi video tutorial. I wanted to do a similar exercise to the wire bottle which I did in Inventor. In Inventor I did it with a 3D curve by equation. This tool is available in Kati Wi-Fi, but sadly I don't have access to a license which includes that workbench. So I had to do it with two laws, and it's almost the same. So let's have some fun with Kati Wi-Fi. Okay, first I need a sketch, maybe on the YZ plane, doesn't really matter. Hide these yellow projected elements as usual, then go for a line, give it some constraints, so that point should be right on that one and of course on that axis as well. Then align these two and give it a length, and that might be 200. Okay, I need this as reference line. Then I want to do two laws, so go for FOG right here, no one, okay, and I create one new parameter of type length, and that would be x, and another one, an angle, new parameter type, and I will call this one alpha, doesn't really matter, just give it a name, and the law would be x equals cosinus of alpha multiplied with pi multiplied with 40. Of course, you could change all those parameters for yourself and adjust the model. Multiplied with 60 millimeter, multiplied with cosinus, that's for the dampening of the curve, alpha multiplied with 3 divided by 2 divided by 2 multiplied with pi plus at, for example, pi divided by 2. You don't have to use pi here and here. You could use another constant or just simple values, but you would have to take care for the units. And I need a similar formula in my second law, so I will copy it. Control C for copy. Let's okay. Now I got the relations, that law, and you need to do a parallel curve. So go for no, that's the parallel curve. Parallel curve. Use that as reference. This one as support. And give it a law, and that law would be this one, and close it, and okay, that's my first curve. And my second law would be, here you go, FOG, confirm. I need again an angle, and I would call this beta and a new one, a length, new parameter, and I would call this one y. Okay, and the formula would be y equals control v, and now change, delete that. Delete this one and use sinus This should be beta. Same formula, just replace alpha with beta. Okay. And again, make a parallel curve. Now use again sketch 1 as reference. Support should be now that plane. Doesn't matter if you choose that X, Y or that Z, you have to choose two different planes. And the first one was automatically selected, it was this one. But I could go back and make sure it's that one. And the law would be the second one. And close. And OK. So let's check our law, because that should be sinus and then it should be cosinus. Yes, that's okay. Now you could make a combined curve. Go back to generative shape design and go for a combined curve. So this one and that one, and you get a nice 3D curve. Let's hide those two. And now I could go for a circular sweep. Please take notice, if you have too many of those turns, you would get an error message and it would say that spline or spine is too long. That's kind of odd, but it happened. So I adjusted these values to 40. With 50 it doesn't work, with 60 only with smaller values. Okay, now let's go for a sweep, for a circular sweep. Go to generative shape design, go for sweep, use a circular one, send in radius. A radius might be 4, center curve is this one. And confirm. Takes a while, and here it is. Hide the sketch. Now make this one active, switch to the part design environment, and close that surface. This one, no, that one, that's the sweep. Okay, hide the combined curve, hide the sweep. You could apply some material, for example, chroma to this one. Very nice. And now I made a circular pattern, because it's faster to do than to change the formulas. And that would be one with a complete crown, two instances, and the axis would be this axis. The current solid will be patterned, confirm. Takes a while. And then I used a second plane to cut that off. So go for a plane. There you are. Make it with a distance to that plane. Reverse direction. Make it, for example, 30. Yeah. Or maybe make it 40. Whatever you want. And then split the body with that plane. This will be, that will remain and that will be removed. So okay, and I'm done. So I hope you enjoyed this one. If you liked it, please give it a like, leave a comment. If you want to see more, please give it a like, leave a comment. please subscribe to my YouTube channel, please subscribe to my Facebook fan page, would be very nice of you. So please subscribe and like. Thanks for watching. See you to the next one. Bye bye.